This week on the Rumorg Archives, we head back to October 2010 for Rumorg issue number 105. Rumorg enlists modern horror master Wes Craven to celebrate the lunatic legacy of Alfred Hitchcock's Psycho in a feature titled We All Go a Little Mad Sometimes by Aaron Von Lupton. By the late 1950s, Alfred Hitchcock had solidified himself as one of the premier movers in Hollywood. This was certainly true after the release of his 1959 thriller North by Northwest, which was nominated for 3 Oscars and was one of the top-grossing hits of the year. Hitchcock clearly was the man, but instead of continuing down the path of mainstream blockbusters, he chose a new angle for his next project. A low-budget production based on Robert Bloch's pulp novel Psycho, published that same year, and based on real-life Wisconsin grave robber, murderer, and future Leatherface inspiration, Ed Gein. Though he was under contract to Paramount, the studio refused to support what they saw as a repulsive, impossible-to-film B-movie. Ever the entrepreneur, the director took his Alfred Hitchcock Presents TV crew and financed the movie himself for roughly $800,000. Hitchcock was going to prove that he could make a quality movie on the cheap. This was a project where he could have fun both with audiences and at their expense. Like a master magician, Hitchcock fashioned a movie based around the manipulation of viewer expectations. To that extent, he considered Psycho not only a horror film, but a black comedy. His number one trick would be that, just when audiences were getting caught up in the story about a woman on the run with 40 grand, he would kill her off in the most brutal and harrowing scene ever depicted on screen up to that point, and she would be played by a major leading lady, Janet Leigh. Many say that Psycho is the most important horror movie ever made because it gave birth to a new kind of monster in cinema, the human monster, and pushed the genre forward into new territory. To look deeper into the influence of the film, Rumorg assembled a panel of experts, including modern horror master Wes Craven, whose latest film, My Soul to Take, hits theaters this month. Describe your experience of seeing Psycho for the first time. I saw it when I was in college, years after it came out, and I was struck by how far ahead of its time it was, and how sophisticated it was, and how radical and daring it was. Not just for the shower scene, but in killing off a major character in the first part of the film. That was an extraordinarily daring thing to do. Why did Hitchcock want the film to be in black and white? How would it have been different in color? I think having it in black and white simplifies things in a way that you can better focus your attention. There's just more distraction in the frame with color. I think modern filmmakers have in some ways brought us back to black and white. You know, taking color out of the prints. The Matrix did that. Modern films tend to have a gray-blue thing going on. Would you say that Psycho's legacy is mostly negative? It's funny because most people that didn't like the violence in my films always pointed to Psycho and said, Hitchcock killed a woman in a shower, but you never actually saw any blood. I can remember when that film came out and my parents and all their friends were horrified by it. It was a masterpiece, but I don't think it opened any sort of portal. What it did do was use violence and horror with major stars so that it appealed to a much wider audience. It didn't really smash any sexual barriers, it was just graphically violent, but certainly not by today's standards. What did you think of the Gus Van Sant remake? I didn't see it. I didn't want to ruin my experience of the original. I shouldn't say that because I've done remakes of my own films, but I didn't want my last memory of Psycho to be of something else, especially something shot for shot. Psycho probably ranks as one of the most legitimately scary movies of all time. What made it so frightening? When Mother comes out of that doorway and attacks the cop at the top of the stairs, then the cop falls backwards in that kind of surreal shot, I was scared out of my wits. The shower scene is very hard to bear, but at the same time you can tell it's a very carefully constructed set piece and that all the shots come off storyboards. But that one moment of the woman coming out, it's so visceral. It's like an immediate shot and you're not seeing things clearly and you've lost your ability to see things dimensionally correct. I remember it was a very strangely processed shot. It almost looks dreamlike. One of the things about it is that she comes a long distance to get to him. It's not like she just pops out of the doorway, she does this kind of long sprint, and the trick is that he made it scary the whole way. Why did Hitchcock insist Psycho was a comedy? I've often told people that making horror films is a kind of gallows humor joke. I mean, we can go to horror films and scream, but in the end we're still safe and we come out okay. Horror movies are kind of a joke about that. When you think about it, people often applaud and laugh, especially after you've killed someone in the most gruesome way. Why is that? I guess it's because it's a way to deal with the reminder that life is often swift and short and can end arbitrarily. And that's it for this episode of the Rumorg Archives. For the transcript of our interview with Wes Craven and others talking about Alfred Hitchcock's Psycho, be sure to pick up Rumorg number 105, October 2010 issue. now available in print and digital from the links below. Join us next time for another classic feature from the pages of Rumorg Magazine.